Here's the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community. When social distancing and COVID safety protocols reduced the number of available slots for consular services at the Philippine Consulate General in New York, it led to a backlog in services.
Hindi po ba pwede na magkaroon ng mas maraming manpower upang magkaroon ng mas malawakang o madaling schedule ang ating mga kababayan para makakuha ng pasaporte at magkaroon din, makakuha din sila ng proseso sa pagkakaroon ng dual citizenship.
For the past year, we really, really were affected so hard in terms of us being forced to limit the number of kababayans we could serve.
Conchon Cato says since then they've made improvements. In fact, beginning April this year, the number of consular services increased by nearly 50% after adding 200 additional passport appointment slots per month, plus opening consulate doors on certain Saturdays. And finally, in Virginia Beach, Virginia, at the global headquarters of Operation Smile, where the Anthony L. Hideko S. Burgess Interactive Learning Center was recently built, members of the Filipino community were recognized for their contributions to the organization.
You're very, very special people, and without you, Operation Smile would not be where it is today with 6,000 volunteers.
The center allows visitors to learn more about the patients and families that Operation Smile serves in over 80 countries, especially the Philippines, where it all began.
Operation Smile, by God's grace, they rescued me.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tscnews and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to Mike and Nikki for the rundown.